Yahweh, that's the name of the Heavenly Father that's sitting on his throne, who the world calls God. And Yahweh Shai, that's the name of the who the world ignorant calls Jesus Christ. That's who we worship. And that's the true powers of the heavens and the earth, the God of the Bible. We're going to say double unto the apostles, a great millstone over there in New York, Apostle Tahar, Apostle Gabar on down. And Shalom Wakasal Lahabakya, which is peace and mercy to election out there pushing his word in sincerity and truth. Thankful to the Most High for allowing his brothers to get together today. And the topic, what we finna go into, is Esau's witchcraft. Esau witchcraft and how Yahweh Bashimah Shah finna take it down. Yeah. Could you see over there in London, what's going on over there in London, like the brother, the brother in London, Yaquara Kwam, I believe that's his name. Yeah, he made a video saying what's going on in London. You know, and then you got the building that was burnt down. And then they reported that only like, what, 17 people was it?
Yeah,
17 people died. But then you got that girl that came out with that testimony saying like over 500 people died. So me and your brothers concluded, man, that was a sacrifice, man. Yeah. That was a sacrifice. And then you see them reoccurring events over there and over there in London that's back to back. Because what it is they're doing, they're performing some type of rituals, man, to gain some type of power. Which the ultimate power they're trying to gain to is what? That power of the New World Order, man. And how they do it? By playing on the minds and masses of the people, which goes all the way back to witchcraft.
Yeah.
You know, let's drop that Corinthians.
Oh, yep. 2 Corinthians verse 11. It says, lest Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices.
Look, the Yahweh Shemel Shai has opened up his elect men to be on a whole nother frequency, a whole nother level than the people in the world. So when we see what Esau is doing, we automatically know what's going on, what's going down. And then we revert back to these scriptures. That's how we understand. So when you go back to the scriptures, we're going to jump into it. We're going to go into the origins on how Esau, where he even got this mentality of doing all this fucking witchcraft, which it goes all the way back to the Hamites. That's what this goes back to, man. Esau doing what the Hamites did. Remember, it was recorded that we was in slavery under the Egyptians for 430 years, man. 30 years of when we was with Joseph, right, in peace. And then 400 years of when a new Pharaoh came up and put vigorous slavery on us, man. Esau admires that. How can I keep these niggas in this same amount of, the same time period of slavery and more?
Yeah.
What was the Egyptians doing to keep Jacob in slavery? And then when you read the Exodus, you find out what they was doing when they were trying to mimic what Moses was bringing with the Lord, from the Lord. They were trying to mimic it by doing witchcraft. Mimic Moses, man. And the Edomite devil, he admires that, and he's performing that to keep his power ruling, trying to keep us enslaved for a long period of time, like the Egyptians, man.
Yeah. Another way he was, he keep our people worshiping that same golden calf, man, is through like the championship, trophies, and you know, the trophy with the, you know, they just won the
NBA,
and they was worshiping this gold fucking, statue,
yeah,
man.
That's what's trophy, yeah.
Trophy, you know? The boxers, they worship their belts. The Olympians, they worship their gold.
Medals.
Everything is gold that they worship. They even in the music, they get a golden, what is
BET
that?
BET Awards or something?
Yeah.
What is, I don't know what it's called.
Certified gold, like the record?
Yeah, gold records.
Platinum.
Yeah,
platinum records. Gold, what is that shit? It's like a woman with wings or some shit for the Oscars.
Yeah.
You know?
Grammys.
And they still got our people worshiping, you know, it's a different shape and form, but it's still the same, what's the word?
Is it worship?
The idol, it's still the same worship of the idols, man.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, so they doing the same, it's just being recycled. In a way that it's not like, okay, you know you worshiping this damn false sight. No, they camouflaged it. Mm-hmm. Like, you won this thing because of your greatness. No, they gave you that so you can fall, man. So you could further be in that sunken place.
Yeah, that's right, man. That's right. Yeah. Let's see. Go ahead, bro.
This is Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 12, verse 3. For it was thy will to destroy by the hands of our fathers both those old inhabitants of thy holy land.
That's talking about Joshua. The old inhabitants of thy holy land was the Hamites that was in there. And by our fathers, we destroyed them out of there. Remember, Joshua came in there and we took over and we set up shop. And then it's going to tell you why the Most High did that. Why he destroyed the old inhabitants that was there, which was the Hamites. Go ahead, bro.
It says, verse 4, 12. Whom thou hatest for doing most odious works of witchcrafts and wicked sacrifices, and also those merciless murderers of children.
That was all what Ham was doing in that land, bro. They were sacrificing children to Molech, you know? All these different gods they were sacrificing to. Killing each other kids, man. To gain some type of status or power. It's even recorded in the scriptures that you had, I forgot what man it was, but he was losing a battle and he sacrificed his son on the spot so that he could win, man. You know? So you had people that was in the midst of a battle, they'd be losing, they'll hurry up and sacrifice somebody to gain some type of power on the left-hand side. Because when you do that type of stuff, you summon demons from the left-hand side, man. Which is energy, which is things that outweighs the human, the realm we in. So they could come in and destroy fast, you know? But they doing it in a wicked way. That's what them Hamites was doing. Yeah. And that's what Esau admired. You got something?
I was just saying, when you sacrificing on the left-hand side, that requires blood, man.
Yeah.
It requires a lot of bloodshed. Just like we seen to happen on that building in London, man.
Yeah.
That was over 500 people that perished, man.
That's a lot of blood.
That's a lot of people that died, man. Hey, ultimately it was the Heavenly Father, though.
Yeah.
You know?
That's right, bro. That's right. Go ahead, yeah, let's drop that real quick. Okay.
Deuteronomy 12 and 12. It says, and ye shall rejoice before the Lord your power.
Is that the one we're talking about, the land? That's the one.
But this is Deuteronomy 11:11. It says, but the land whither ye go to possess it, it is a land of hills and valleys, and drinketh water of the rain of heaven. And a land which of the Lord thy power careth for. The eyes of the Lord thy power are always upon it, from the beginning of the year even unto the end of the year.
So the Most High seen what the Hamites were doing in our land over there. That was his land. And what was they doing? Let's jump back to the Wisdom of Solomon, bro.
It said, verse 4, for whom thou hatest for doing most odious works of witchcrafts and wicked sacrifices, and also those merciless murders of children.
Don't you see Esau killing children mercilessly?
Yeah.
It's even the videos like Yashawamba put out and certain other videos concerning the Pizzagate situations, man. They said that their favorite part of the sacrifices is seeing the child scream to his death and seeing the spirit leave the baby, man.
Yeah.
That's a merciless child killer, man.
That's how they get most of their powers, from sacrificing children.
Yeah.
They get the most power from sacrificing, you know, children and shit, man.
Yeah.
And drinking their blood.
Yeah. Let's go, bro.
It says, also those merciless murderers of children and devourers of man's flesh, and the feast of blood.
Feast of blood. What do we saw do now? This dude be drinking blood, just like the Hamites was doing, man.
Yeah.
Drinking blood, man. You know? Taking on another person, because blood is life.
Yeah.
Drinking another person's life, man. Yeah. That shit's wicked. And it's all to summon, keep that vibration, that frequency of demons all around to keep his kingdom going, man. Go ahead, all right.
It says, with their priests out of the midst of the idolatrous crew, and the parents that killed with their own hands souls destitute of help.
And you even had, back then you had the Hamites, they bring their child to sacrifice their children, man. And that's what they do over there in the Bohemian Grove. Like we be explaining on the street. If a woman get pregnant at the Bohemian Grove, she don't know who's the who's the baby daddy or the father of the child, because it's a big old orgy, right? So what she do the next after she have the baby, the next Bohemian Grove, they sacrifice that child that the woman had, man. And she gets a boost of, you know, demonic energy, which is prosperous in this world. She may get, she go back to wherever she, her life is, she get bumped up in a company, or she get brand new cars, $1 million this, $1 million that. Mm-hmm. You know? Doing that shit that the Hamites was doing. That's what Esau doing today. And that's what you see over there in London. Witchcraft being performed.
Yeah, like these actresses, they get bumped up in the roles. You know, they get these top-notch roles that's paying like between 10 and 15 million a role. You know, they start making that money, that star, that super high star money, man.
Yeah, they call it clubs, bro.
Clubs?
Like that $1 million club.
Yeah.
Woo-woo club, this club, you know?
Yeah. So they start getting those high roles. They start getting recognition, more fame, you know, magazine covers. They start being basically the man, you know,
mm-hmm.
the one, you know?
Yep, yep, that's right.
I'll say something too. Mm-hmm. Like, yep. You got actors like Will Smith. Like, he in the Illuminati, so his son, Jaden Smith,
Ooh.
He's born right into it. So,
yeah.
That's a sacrifice.
He sacrificed his son. You know?
Damn. Gave him over to the devil.
Yeah.
Damn.
Damn. That's right.
Good. This is verse 7. It says, that the land which thou esteemest above all other,
Deuteronomy 11 and 11 and 12, right? The land that the Most High esteemed above all others.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Might receive a worthy colony of the Most High's children.
You see that right there? And that's why the Hamites got took down. They got took down because they were doing witchcraft. And the Most High said, so that a worthy colony of the children of the Most High may inhabit that land, which was us.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And that's the book of the Exodus to the Genesis. Or even from Genesis to Joshua when he got us in here, man. You know? I think, is that it? Oh, yeah. Well, read verse 8, bro.
It says, nevertheless, even those that thou sparedest as men, and didst send wasps, forerunners of thine hosts, to destroy them by little and little.
And that's how the Most High got them Hamites out of there. He destroyed their ass, man, for performing that witchcraft. The Most High can't. What was going on in that land, the Most High couldn't even. If his eyes, that's his favorite land, that's where his eyes is always at. And the Hamites were doing all that. The Most High had to get them out of there, man. So it goes to show you that Yahweh Shemar Shai is finna get the damn white man out of here. Because he got the whole world on his thing of doing witchcraft, man.
13.
Okay, you got it?
Yeah.
Go ahead,
Habakkuk 1 and 13. It says, thou art of pure eyes than to behold evil, and canst not look on iniquity.
You see that right there?
Man, that's why he turned his head away from Israel, man. Mm-hmm. Because our people was fucking wicked as hell, man.
Yeah.
Worshiping everything under the sun, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know, trying to sneak off and worship shit.
Yeah, that's it. Nigga, Nigga sneak off, go worship something in the cut.
Like the Heavenly Father ain't watching your stupid ass.
And this dude Esau, man, he got the whole world like on this want to worship Satan vibe now.
Yeah.
I see people walking around now with that Baphomet head on their shirt, but they think it's Satan. That shit is Satan on their shirt, man. Mm-hmm. You know? And it just everybody now it's people that will literally they know all what you gotta do to music to what you gotta do to get in the music industry and they still do it. Mm-hmm. And then the New World Order is the base off of worship of Satan. Do what thou will is gonna be the whole New World Order, man. And the worshiping of Satan.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
With the Rothschilds calling the shots.
Isaiah.
Most I gonna take this damn white man witchcraft down. Yep, go ahead.
As Isaiah start at 1. Mm-hmm. It says, come down,
and sit in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon. Sit on the ground, there is no throne.
Hey, look, it said, come and sit in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon. Then said, read it again, bro. What it says? Says,
come down and sit in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon.
Uh-huh.
Sit on the ground, there is no throne, O daughter of the Chaldeans.
The daughter of the Chaldeans. Remember, the Chaldeans was the sorceress of Babylon, man. So that's why Esau is called that. That's why he's called Babylon and, you know, cold words and Chaldean. Because you're doing witchcraft like them. You're doing the same thing that they did. You know?
Yeah. Do it out. It says, for thou shalt no more be called tender and delicate. Take the millstones and grind meal. Uncover thy locks. Make bare the leg.
And that's how we finding out everything this devil doing to get where he at. Yeah. We know when he's summoning up Satan. He got a seat for Satan when they get to their super top rituals. And Satan appear before them and tell them what the deal is. And then that video we posted with the dude who was a super Satanist. That dude said that Satan would come and appear to him and tell him little things to do, man. And he start calling Satan his daddy.
I was going into hospitals and putting deaf in ICU, deaf in one room so this person can die because I wanted to be promoted with the devil to move up that ranks to be the biggest devil worshiper in New York City. The devil became my daddy. He replaced my dad because I prayed and I said, you kill my dad. At the age of 33 years old, my dad got shot in a nightclub in the face for a woman that wasn't even his when he had to go woman home. And the devil took him out. The devil said, I replaced the old to keep the new. And the devil became my daddy.
So Esau, his daddy is Satan, man.
John.
Go ahead.
John, what's that?
44, it says, for thou shalt no more be called tender and delicate. Take the millstones and grind meal. Uncover thy locks. Make bare the leg. Uncover the thigh. Pass over the rivers. Mm-hmm. It says, thy nakedness shall be uncovered. Yea, thy shame shall be seen. I will take vengeance, and I will not meet thee as a man.
And that's why we see everything Esau doing now. It's to the point now, you got the men of the Lord with the Spirit of the Most High on them, telling this damn white man you're going down. And we also tell you that Yahweh Shai is coming back, and he's not coming to planet Earth like he came the first time. This time he's coming with the host of heaven, and he's coming in his glorious power to knock all what Esau's witchcraft, what he's doing down. It's going to go down.
Yeah.
It's going to come to a point in time where Esau is going to try to do his witchcraft, and there's going to be no results. No results. Because the Most High is going to cut him off from that left hand, man.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
I'm going to skip down to verse 9.
Yeah.
It says, but these two things shall come to thee in a moment, in one day, the loss of children and widowhood. They shall come upon thee in their perfection, for the multitude of thy sorceries and for the great abundance of thine enchantments.
Yep, because of your sorceries, man. What you doing? Your deceptiveness, man. That's why we call you the damn devil. We call you the devil because how you got the planet Earth was through witchcraft. And even show you in that old Twilight clip. The old Twilight clip that the brother over there, Charlotte, posted. And I reposted
Twilight Zone. Yeah.
Twilight Zone, yep. Twilight Zone clip of subliminals in Hollywood. But the damn dude told him, look, man, Satan, your part is for Satan. Satan is going to fight for you, man.
You find everything you need in this book. Spells. Talisman. Curses, everything. Here, take it. Don't seem right. Don't seem right at all. There's something unclean. Like being in league with the...
That's it. You got it right, Johnny Rear. You said it like it's got to be said. The devil. That's who you're in league with. The devil himself. That's who we'll have fighting on our side. The devil. The devil. The devil. The devil.
And that's how the devil did it. He came in with Satan on his right hand, and he was swinging with Satan behind it, which was using deception to get the whole planet Earth.
Yeah. What it is, Esau, through the scriptures, through his actions and his spirit, he know that he's the devil. Mm-hmm. So if you know you the devil, hey, why not get the devil, Satan, why not get Satan to help you, man?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Why not go full force with it?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You know the Heavenly Father ain't dealing with you, so you ain't gonna pray to the Heavenly Father and try to get right. So you know the devil, so you're gonna stick to the devil role, man. Praying to Satan and doing his will, man.
Yeah, sure.
That's how you get strong. It's through Satan, man.
Yeah. He's the opposite of us, the literal opposite.
Yeah.
So he gotta do what's on the wicked side.
Yeah.
And that's how he prevails.
Yeah.
You know?
Verse 10, it says, "For thou hast trusted in thy wickedness. Thou hast said, none seeth me. Thy wisdom and thy knowledge, it hath perverted thee.
Mm.
And thou hast said in thine heart, I am and none else besides me."
You see that right there? The white man got so proud with him prevailing and doing witchcraft, he believed that nobody could touch him now, not even the Most High now, man. Stupid, when you do, this devil know that Satan works for the Most High. Job, the second chapter, the elites read that, you know? But it's not really he could do because, like we said, he's appointed to that. That's his lot,
yeah,
to do that, man. And even in that Twilight Zone clip, the scene to me, I don't know what the scene was about, or what was going on in the actual movie, but the clip looked like when Esau was trying to come over here and take over Gad. That's what it looked like cowboys type shit. And they was losing. He said, "We losing the war." Who was they losing the war to? They was losing the war to Gad. Because remember, when Esau first came over here, Gad was lighting their ass up, man. Lighting them up. Esau had found that book of witchcraft. Some of them demons, I'm just, you know, speculating. Off of the Twilight Zone clip, found that book of witchcraft, some of them demons, and who knows, the Most High put the idea of making the Gatling gun in one of the devil's head, man. Mm-hmm. And next thing you know, Gad can't do nothing no more.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And the prophecy of our land gets, the prophecy of our land being, or Esau coming over here taking the land, came to pass, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But let's keep going, bro. Slot.
This is back in Isaiah 47.
Matter of fact, bro, just keep reading down. Keep reading down. Mm-hmm.
47:11. It says, "Therefore shall evil come upon thee, and shall not know from whence it rises, and mischief shall fall upon thee. Thou shalt no more be able to put it off. And desolation shall come upon thee suddenly, which thou shalt not know."
So the Most High is going to take this damn devil down in his witchcraft. Mm-hmm. He ain't going to even see it coming, man. Mm-hmm. Yep, go ahead, Doc.
It says, "Stand now with thine enchantments, and with the multitude of thy sorceries, wherein thou hast labored from thy youth. If so be thou shalt be able to profit, if so be thou mayest prevail.
Mm-hmm.
Thou art weary in the multitude of thy counsels. Let now the astrologers, the stargazers, the monthly pronosticators, stand up and save thee from these things that shall come upon thee."
So the Most High is saying, okay, use your witchcraft when Yahweh Shai come back, basically. Let's see if that's going to work. And we know it ain't going to work, man. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Remember, Yahweh Shai, when he would free a demon from one of the jakes that was in the New Testament, the demon would be scared. Is it the time?
Yeah, yeah.
Is it the time? Even the demons obey Yahweh Shai.
Yeah.
He had power over everything in the heavens and the earth, man. So let's see if Esau witchcraft prevails then.
Verse 14.
That's it right there, bro.
Oh, okay. Come on. This is Micah 5:12. Mm-hmm. It says, "And I will cut off witchcrafts out of thine hand, and thou shalt have no more soothsayers. Thy graven images also will I cut off, and thy standing images out of the midst of thee, mm-hmm. and thou shalt no more worship the work of thine hand."
So no more Baphomet, no more fucking that wall over there in the land of Israel, that bullshit wall. No more trophies like this brother saying, American Idol. No more nothing, man. The Most High gonna cut everything off that this devil got going, man. No more obelisks. No more demonic buildings and gargoyles.
Yeah.
And you know what I mean?
Outlining the streets with fucking satanic symbols.
Yeah. Demonic layout of the streets.
Yeah.
Most High gonna get rid of all that. And then that punk ass, big ass Cesar Borgia over there in Brazil. Man, Lord gonna get rid of everything, man, this devil got. Yeah. Go ahead, all right.
Verse 14. And I will pluck up thy groves out of the midst of thee, so will I destroy thy cities.
Okay, so no more churches, no more satanic temples. And then you go destroy your cities, man. No more Los Angeles, no more New York, man.
Yeah.
Etc. Go ahead, all right.
And I will execute vengeance in anger and fury upon the heathen, such as they have not heard.
Ooh, so the Esau thinking of all his plans of witchcraft on how he gonna take Israel and keep the world, Most High gonna shut it down, man.
Yeah.
And that's the time we in. We in the time of Esau's witchcraft being cut off, man.
Yeah.
You know? That
was
it?
Yes,
yeah. This is Nahum chapter 3, verse 4. It says, because of the multitude of the whoredoms of the well-favored harlot, the mistress of witchcrafts, that selleth nations through her whoredoms and families through her witchcrafts. Behold, I am against thee, saith the Lord of hosts, and I will discover thy skirts upon thy face, and I will show the nations thy nakedness.
So it just showed you, it just told you that the way Esau got this land was through witchcraft. And that way he got the whole world was through witchcraft. You know what I'm saying? Then the Most High gonna put a stop to this, man. This dude, he's going buck wild with this witchcraft, man.
Yeah.
Aleister Crowley is held up high in this place.
Yeah,
yeah. Antoine Lavette, that damn Scientology founder, he's held up. Man, we just walked past that street on Colorado Street.
Yeah,
on Colorado Street they had that Antoine Lavette Scientology store.
Yeah.
A retail store, not a church building, an actual retail store.
Like that
L. Ron Herbert and all that.
Yeah.
That's what I mean, Slocky, which Antoine LeVent and Ron Herbert fucking was together in league with each other and shit. Same motherfucker believing the same shit type shit. But yeah, man, they had a retail store of just books you could buy, little gadgets you could get, you know, souvenirs.
When you look in the windows, the way it was set up, it looked like demonic, man.
Demonic. Damn.
It looked weird, like, what the fuck?
And then everybody on that street out doing their thing, not even knowing it's a giant demon that just posts right there.
Yeah.
That fuck with everybody on the street.
It says, and I will show the nations thy nakedness and the kingdoms thy shame.
Mm-hmm. So everybody, that's why nobody's scared of America no more. They're like, look at them faggots over there.
Yeah.
Look at them faggots. That witchcraft that got to these niggas, man. Now motherfuckers really think that being a gay is cool. Like this nigga Polite, man.
Oh, man.
That nigga do witchcraft like a motherfucker, bro. He do witchcraft. You know you gotta be under a spell to think that homosexuality is cool. Or a nigga shaking his ass up and down is cool, man. That nigga got caught trying to be off the camera. Nigga, the camera got you, nigga. Go ahead though, bro.
That was
Yeah, you got that, bro? Or you got one?
Oh, yeah, Numbers?
Yep.
This is Numbers 23 and 23. It says, surely there is no enchantment against Jacob, neither is there any divination against Israel.
See, the two-third Jakes right now, the Most High is allowing them to fucking be consumed by that witchcraft, but Yahweh Shemal Shai is as preserved. Oh, go to Romans 11 and 7. The Most High has preserved a set amount of men to not be fooled with that bull, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We're not fooled with this witchcraft, man. It's to the point, it's like, goddamn, man. Nobody even care no more. The elect, man, hey, do what you're going to fucking do. Y'all shot going to come destroy you, man.
Yeah.
Talking about this damn devil. You know? There's going to be more motherfuckers he going to kill. More pedophile rings gonna be discovered.
Yeah.
Until Yahweh Shai come and destroy this dude, he gonna continue to do what he do, sacrifice animals. make people eat human shit, blackmail Jake that's in the industry, you know, to get them to do that stuff that they do, man. Yeah.
They just killed the Jake. I don't know how old the video, but it don't look like it was that old. Mm-hmm. Brother sent it. Basically, they pulled Jake over, and Jake, the cop, you know, walks up, and then you see another cop walk up. It was on the police dash cam, and he's basically saying, yeah, you know, I got a firearm in the car. And then immediately the fucking cop got nervous and shit, you know, holding his gun and shit, pulled it out. And then he was like, don't touch it, don't touch it. Let me see your hand. And then dude just pop, 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 pop. Just when I was nervous fucking
nervous shot
and shit. Dumped like five of them into Jake and shit. His baby in the back, his wife is in the front and shit. You know, his wife's screaming and shit. Fucking Jake laid out. You know what I'm saying?
Damn.
And then Edom all huffing and puffing, breathing all hard, talking about fuck, fuck. Like if something happened to your punk ass. Yeah. Like you got hurt or some shit.
Yeah.
You just fucking fired like five or six shots up in the Jake, man. That shit had me hot, you know what I'm saying? Because, hey, they two-thirds, but at the same time, man, they are people, man.
They are people.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? That still make you hot. I don't give a fuck, man.
Yeah.
You know? That boils you up, man. Mm-hmm. Hey, Matter of fact, let me just grab it, man. This is Ecclesiastes 7:7. Mm-hmm. You know, because what it is oppression, man. You know,
yep.
This is Ecclesiastes 7:7. Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad, and a gift destroyeth the heart. But the point is, oppression maketh a wise man mad, man. Because you know, the more wisdom you get, the more, what does scripture say?
Grief.
You know? Why? Because you got the wisdom now to know who your enemy is, what he been doing to you over the years, what he's still doing to you, how he doing it, how he's oppressing your people, you know, poisoning every goddamn thing. You can't do nothing to him. You know, we gotta wait on Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, you know. But hey, at the end of the day, that's gonna be the beautiful thing, man. Is that this little bit of weight that we weigh, because it's a little bit of weight, man. We just in the flesh and we just want everything to be quick. But it's a little weight, man. When Yahweh Shai come back, man, he gonna set everything straight, man.
Mm-hmm.
He gonna take this kingdom, man.
Yeah, that's right.
And all you damn devils that think you got the next rule, man, you got another thing coming, man.
Yeah.
You ain't got shit. You ain't gonna rule shit, man.
Mm-hmm.
Alright? You got pure hardcore slavery coming, man.
That's it.
And that's it, man.
Yeah.
You gonna see, you looking at the men that you killing on the street, those are your future kings, man.
Yeah.
Your future slave masters, man.
Yeah.
So you got hell coming, man.
That's right.
Revelations 13, man. You going into hardcore slavery.
Yeah, that's right, man.
You know?
Hell yeah, man. If we catch you trying to do some type of witchcraft or some type of sorcery in the kingdom, we are going to lob your head off your shoulders instantly, man.
Instantly.
You know? We catch you over there trying to sacrifice a goat. You know, or trying to do some shit. Trying to do some type of homosexual act. Trying to do anything. We going to lay you flat.
Yeah.
Because ain't going to be none of that witchcraft going down. Ain't going to be no more oppressing us. Going down no more, man.
And first of all, Esau ain't gonna get a chance to have a goat.
No, man.
So, you know, he ain't gonna even have a chance to have a goat. No, nothing. The sacrifice, do nothing, man. You gonna be told when you gonna eat, when you could take a shit, all that shit, man.
Yeah.
You can drink water. You know, when you could take a break, and you barely gonna even have any breaks, man.
Yeah.
The scriptures say. Matter of fact, let me get it. Wasn't a Solomon, it's right here, it's spirit.
Yeah, it's spirit.
Wasn't a Solomon 12:12. Therefore, whereas thou dost chasten us, you know, the Heavenly Father chasten us, thou scourgest our enemies 1,000 times more.
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to receive it that much more in the kingdom, man. Yeah. We're going to meditate terrors. We're going to be thinking like, damn, what I'm going to do to this dude?
Oh,
you know, I can't. just peel the skin off them, just throw them into a pit of alcohol. Oh, and just let you, and just let you die slow, man. Put you in a deep ass pool of alcohol, man. After your skin is peeled off your ass, every movement of trying to stay afloat is burning the shit out your ass, man. You know what I'm saying? Bury your ass with your head, with your just your head above the dirt, and have a stampede, man, of fucking rhinos and shit, man. And have them rhinos and buffalo and have them fucking stump your fucking head in, man. Just, these are terrorists on the lowly without spiritual power, man. So how much more with spiritual power we gonna be thinking of terrorists for your ass, man? Yeah. It's gonna be perfected, man.
Have some fire and army ants.
You know?
Them ants from Indiana Jones.
It's this one place they put your hand into like this big ass leaf thing.
Uh-huh.
And it's like a ritual. And them shits just bite the shit out of you, man. Ooh. And they say that shit is so fucking
painful.
Painful, man. I'm talking about, you know, not too many people can handle that shit, man.
Yeah.
You know?
Just have a field to eat them mice heads. Just stampede.
Yeah. Yeah. Hell yeah.
The fucking stampede of death pit. But yeah, with that, man, you know, just a quick, unless you know, we got a quick one?
Oh, shoot. This
back yeah, yeah, another drop. Yep, yep.
This is Baruch chapter 4, verse 25. It says, my children, suffer patiently the wrath that has come upon you from the heavenly Father.
Whoa, that's real comforting.
For thine enemy hath persecuted thee, but shortly thou shalt see his destruction, and thou shalt tread upon his neck.
And the brother just described literal tread upon his neck. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna get a big ass elephant, baby elephant foot. God damn, that shit gonna hurt. But yeah, with that, man, through Spirit Y'all Rush from Outside, we hope this lesson was edifying. Going into bitch ass Eden, where he fucking even thought to do the witchcraft from it and how he's using it.
Yeah.
You know, through the Spirit of the Lord, how the Y'all Rush from Outside gonna take that witchcraft down, man. And then we gonna stand on top and we gonna jack him up without doing no rituals. You
That's
know what
right.
I'm saying?
That's right.
Yeah, but with that, I'll close it out. I say, Barakatei Yahweh.
Barakatei Yahweh.
Barakatei Yahweh.
Barakatei Yahweh.
Shalom, Makir. Shalom, Stanimo.